New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up Bryce Harper.
Right here, Bryce.
First pitch of the AB now. Harper is one of those prototypical left-handed bats that really excels against right-handed pitching. Sees the ball well coming from that side. 1-0 pitch on the way. And here's a fastball that's nowhere near the zone. It's 2-0 now.
Talk about certain guys in a lineup that you want to be really careful with. This guy right here is one of those, and you can tell he's pitching awfully cautiously.
2-0 count, the pitch. Grounded up the first baseline. He's got it, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton worked a walk his first time up. Pitch on the way. Fouled away. Bases are empty, one man out. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. And smart to lay off there as the fastball misses. It's 1-2 now. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue.
If you're on the mound right there and you're getting a swing at a breaking ball off the plate, do not be shocked if he's tucked something up under this guy's chin hot right here.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
3-2 now.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Now the payoff pitch home. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Acuna's there for it. Two gone. And that'll bring up Keston Hiura. And remember, he hit that two-run homer his first time up.
Yeah, Matt, that last one wasn't exactly a tape measure shot. But listen, a home run is a home run. I know a lot of pitchers, they call that a wall scraper in his last AB. But listen, it counts as a home run nonetheless.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Hit the other way out toward right field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. And now here is Austin Riley, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
The first baseman, Austin Riley.
First pitch coming, here it is. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Fouled off. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Wanted to get the front door curveball on the inside corner there, but it backed up a little and stayed off the corner.
Here comes the 1-2.
Well, that's back-to-back off-speed pitches, and he wasn't biting on either. Now let's see if he goes back to the hard stuff or gives the softer stuff another shot.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Hit down the third baseline. Throw on to first in time, one away. No one on with one down, and digging in now will be Drew Waters. first offering. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's one and one. Two runs, three hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. Popped him up. Hira takes charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out. Stepping in next, Alex Jackson. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one. Two out, nobody on. A ball and a strike. Down low, two balls and a strike. Easy fly ball into shallow center field. In comes the center fielder, and he gets there as he had a lot of ground to cover that time, and the side is retired. Braves are set down 1-2-3. Through four, we're deadlocked at two apiece. All set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Rhys Hoskins.
The first baseman, Rhys Hoskins.
From the stretch. The 0-1 pitch. And so now the Braves will get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. Shin high, that's taken for a ball. And he fouls this one off. Here now the 2-2. There's a shin high slider laid off for a ball. And it's fouled away. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
At the plate, Darryl Cooley, high fly ball out to straightaway center. Acuna's there for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting.
So two out, nobody on. And the pitcher strides into the batter's box. Here's Zach Wheeler. From the stretch, here's the pitch. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Bases are empty here with two men out. Can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to Chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
We got three balls.
Pitch taken, several inches below the zone, in fact.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat, as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
And he misses here, ball four, and somehow he manages to walk his opposite number. Wow.
Well, when you go with a slider there on a full count, you're hoping that the hitter is thinking fastball and swings through it. Didn't work out that way, though. He lays off and gets the free pass.
So next to hit is Joaquin Diaz, man at first after the two-out walk. From the belt, kicks and deals. Now the fastball is swung on and missed.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Pitch is way outside, and that's straight to the backstop. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
Well, the graphic here isn't going to properly show just how far that pitch was from the strike zone. That thing wasn't even close, and I think it made the decision to move up a base pretty easy to make.
Wheeler at second with two down. No offer on that one. 2 balls and a strike.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Can't connect there. It's 2-2. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And another foul ball.
There's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if they have to incorporate that into their mindset.
He's set. The 2-2. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. High in the air out to center field. Acuna able to track it down for the third out. Alejandro Kirk will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. First pitch on its way. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1. He'll check in here at 277. 2 home runs and 6 RBIs. And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in two count and the pitch.
1 ball, 2 strikes.
Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and no one will get this one. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. Hit in the air out to center field. And the pinch hitter is retired here, one away.
The batter number 9.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And standing in, one of the best 2-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. In there at the knees, strike 1. A ball and a strike now to the Atlanta leadoff man. 1 out, nobody on. There's a well-hit ball out to right center field. Simmons racing for second now. And he is in at second base with a 1-out double. But baseball is a game of streaks and runs, and he is on one right now.
Yeah, and you've got to ride these streaks as long as you possibly can, and he's doing that coming in right here. Came into this game on fire with the stick, and he's doing that here.
That's now two hits so far for him in this one. Ozzie Albies is at the plate as he looks at ball one. No hits to this point. Albies with a 1-1 count now. One out and a runner on second base. Had nibbled the corner there, but missed 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Ronald Acuna is on deck. Ready with the 3-1. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
Well, he walked him on five pitches, but that last pitch was really good. He missed down, but only by a hair. When a hitter has a 3-1 count, he can wait until he gets a pitch he loves.
Next to stand in is Ronald Acuna. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. Here's the first pitch to him.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Runners are at first and second with one away. In the dirt, and now let's see. Throw to third, and it's too late as he's in there. So now two men in scoring position.
Man, that is such a wasted opportunity. Two on, one out. Perfect situation to induce a grounder and get out of the inning, but instead he's wild and both runners advance, taking the double play situation away.
Runners are at second and third with one down. 3-0 now.
Definitely in a tough situation facing the three hitter. You can work around him and maybe walk him to load the bases, but that just sets up the cleanup guy with the bases loaded.
Here it is, the 3-0, and he misses again, ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
It was obvious when the count ran to 2-0 that they were not going to give this guy anything to hit. Sometimes you have to pick your battles, and they're going to try their luck with the next hitter.
Striding in is Travis d'Arnaud. It was a walk in his last trip. Now time is called, and this could very well be to buy a few more pitches for those relievers. He's set. Here it comes. There's a breaking ball, but it's laid off and doesn't find the zone.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here. Just to give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
Bases are loaded here, one man out. And this one's on the inside corner, 1-1. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
And he lays off again, ball three.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And this is swung on and missed. Oh, a huge punch out there as the bases remain loaded with two away now.
The third baseman, number 24.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. Wheeler pauses. Here's the first pitch. Now a ball hit in the air, and this looks like it'll get him out of it.
Harper
is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands the bases loaded. A couple of walks, but no damage. Back with more of this Thursday afternoon business person special following this. Drew Smyly takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and set to go is the third baseman, Alec Bohm. First offering.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
I'm sorry, that's cool.
Francisco Lindor will be next. Here it is on 3-1. Got him reaching there. Strike two.
When I broke into the league, not many guys were throwing that elevated fastball with that much velocity on it. The game has changed.
Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball four, so the leadoff hitter is aboard to start the sixth.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. That'll bring up the switch-hitting shortstop and perennial MVP candidate Francisco Lindor. From the belt, kicks and deals. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Jackson moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one. So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring in a dangerous hitter indeed in the form of Bryce Harper. He's set, and the pitch.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in an 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the break. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
Harper behind with an 0-2 count now. Now some action in the Braves' bullpen as they'll stand up a right-hander to get loose. Runner at first here with one away in a 2-2 ball game. And he struck him out. Next, here is Giancarlo Stanton, flew out last time up. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch.
Hey, this one's tied late in the game. As a pitcher right now, you just can't lay a cookie in there 1-0.
Lined hard to center field. Acuna will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. So here is Austin Riley. He'll look to light a spark under this lineup that hasn't found the scoreboard since back in the first inning.
Yeah, and for me, the story has been the starting pitching they faced. It's been very difficult to rebound and, quite frankly, dominate after getting roughed up a bit in the first inning of a start. So I'll give him a lot of credit for what he's been able to do.
And now a pitch on the way. Might have thought about it here, but he lays off the breaking ball inside. It's even at one. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. solo shot here to left. Home run number 16 for him on the year. And Atlanta's taken a 3-2 lead. Sure, you know it's coming after that bomb. That's right. Let's check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, we see it was projected at over 450 feet. An incredible home run to watch. Chris Pather will come on in relief now as he'll make his 35th appearance of the season. And at the plate is Drew Waters. Into the corner and slicing foul. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. Hit weakly back to the mound. And a good throw gets him one gone. So with one gone, time for our look at the current standings. As you can see, these guys really have a comfortable lead in the division race to this point in the season. So next to bat will be Alex Jackson. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. As he'll take a look at ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. A swing and a ground ball to third. Throw gets him, two down. Dansby Swanson will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. Now here's the first offering. As he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. He'll enter play with that batting average still shy of the 220 mark. Four home runs and 17 RBIs. Now a fastball that's taken close that time, but it's 1-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Two out, nobody on. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Harper has a read on it, and that will end the inning. Braves able to tack on another courtesy of the solo shot. The 6-7-8 hitters coming up to start the seventh. It's now 3-2 Atlanta. Willie Batista is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven.